Hi everybody, it's Geordie from Geordie's Cards here for Happy Doodle today, and I am very excited to be able to give you a bit of a sneak peek of some of the products that are going to be dropping in our fall release. So here is the Mischief Makers stamp set. This is just adorable. We have a bunch of foxes. There are four larger ones, one little baby one, and a whole load of accessories, some leaves, a big leaf pile, a little cake, some scarves. Love the stamp set. Next up, we have the Stitched Leaves a backdrop die. This is just gorgeous, and you can use this one portrait or landscape, and I just love its versatility. Next up, we have the Birch Trees panel die. This is a staple in your card making stash. Really, you have to get this one. Love it. And I finally have the Look Who's Talking dies. And I'm going to be using this one in a slightly different way today. I'm using that little speech thought bubble rather, but there are tons of speech bubbles in here, and it's a really great little die set. What I have done is colored and cut out all of my images. I have stamped these out with some VersaFine Onyx Black ink, and then I have heat embossed them with some clear embossing powder. And I have colored them with my Zig Clean Color Real Brush markers. I like to use an embossed line when I am using my Zigs. I find it just easier to keep the water-based markers inside the area I want it if I use that embossing detail. Now, here is that thought bubble from that Look Who's Talking die set. I am using these as my trees today. And here is that birch tree panel die. Isn't it just gorgeous? I have cut it from some craft cardstock. This looks amazing in either white for a winter backdrop, black for a spooky backdrop, or like I've done in this craft cardstock where you can add some leaves to the top of your trees as well. And I'll show you that in a little second here. But first up, this is that gorgeous stitched leaf backdrop die. Isn't it just beautiful? I am ink blending over it, so I have cut it from some Bristol Smooth cardstock. I'm using Scattered Straw, Dried Marigold, and Abandoned Coral for my background here. And I'm just going in kind of pretty messily, really, to create some color on my backdrop. It is just beautiful. You could use this, obviously, as I am, for a fall themed card, but any time of year you could use this as it just creates a gorgeous detail in the background. I love this one. It might be one of my favorites from the new release, although it's pretty hard to pick because there are tons of beautiful products in this new release. Right, so I'm just going back and forth with my blending brushes here to try and create a nice smooth blend between my colors here, getting that transition just how I want it. I will go back in with a little bit more of this dried marigold color. I adore this color. It's possibly one of my favorites from Tim Holtz Distress Oxides, but it is a little bit paler, so I like to go back in with a little bit more to kind of really make that orange pop. Okay, once that is done, I did do some splattering of this off screen with the Abandoned Coral, the Scattered Straw, and then just some water. Okay, next up, here are these thought bubbles, which I have cut from some gorgeous Heffy Doodle Ripened Pumpkin cardstock. And I am going over it with some Spiced Marmalade here. I decided that that wasn't quite dark enough, so I pulled out this ripe persimmon instead, and I'm going to add just a little bit of detail to the bottom of these little pieces. This is, as I say, going to create the kind of leafy tree backdrop that I want for my background. I did do a little bit of splattering here as well, just using that ripe persimmon color there. I'm just going to splatter that all over these little details, and then I'm going to pop these off to the side to dry along with that background panel that I created earlier. Once those pieces are dry, I can start assembling things, but first of all, I'm going to do a little bit of doctoring to my birch tree panel die here. I decided to cut the center two trees out. I didn't want them. I thought I wanted a little bit more of clear space in at the center of my card. Now, The great thing about this die, it's fantastic. You could remove as many or as few as you wanted. If you wanted to cut all of the trees out, you could just have a frame. So it is really, really cool. And you can use it in a lot of different ways. And then obviously those trees that I've cut there, I will be using one of those in a little bit to add a little bit more detail to my card. But before I did anything else, I kind of wanted to figure out where my sentiment was going to go. So I just pulled out my foxes there. I'm going to pull out my background here. It's not quite dry and I'm a little bit impatient. So I hit it with my heat tool just to make sure it was completely dry and I didn't smudge any of those splatters that I had created. And then I'm going to place everything down again and kind of figure out where that sentiment is going to go so that I can get that into the right placement. So there's my little foxes. That's how they're going to look. Here are my tree branches. Now, these aren't going to sit on the top as I have them here, but I just wanted to pop them down for now so I could get the placement of my sentiment. So there they are. Here are some leaves that I'm going to scatter around that I colored in as well. And again, I'm kind of just figuring out where everything is going to go and making sure that I have enough room for everything. Those leaves aren't going to all fit in there. They are going to be scattered around a little bit more, but I like to kind of place things down as I'm going along and make sure that I've got everything kind of going in the right direction. So now I'm going to attach these kind of thought bubble pieces that I created onto the back of my birch trees here. And I'm kind of just doing it from the back and then flicking it over every now and then, make sure that it looks okay. The third one is going to go right in the center and it's just going to kind of create a canopy of trees in the background. And I just love the colors that I've created with these trees. I think it's so pretty and just screams autumn, doesn't it? So here is that extra tree that I cut. And I'm going to pop it in there kind of at an angle so that it looks like it's a branch coming out from the other tree. So it kind of makes that canopy like look like it's meant to be there, like it's not just kind of floating in space. So I'm just attaching that all down with liquid glue. And then I will use my scissors to trim off the edges so that I get that nice straight edge. I did think about putting another branch in there and I kind of fiddled around for a little while thinking, should I do it? Shouldn't I? I decided to leave it. I decided I liked it better without and just kind of, I thought it looked a little bit better as it was. But I do fiddle around a lot. I don't know if you're the same. I like to try things out and kind of, the great thing about this is that you can pop things down without gluing them down in place first and figure out whether you like it or not and then make a decision. So here I am trimming off the edge of those trees just to make sure that it's all flush with the edge of the card. And then I can pull out my background again and work on that sentiment. So that's what it's going to look like. And then I decided, you know what, I actually want the red color at the bottom. So I flipped it around. And as I say, the great thing about that backdrop die, you can use it landscape or portrait. You can use it either way. So it's very versatile. So here I am figuring out again, popping my little images down, making sure I get the placement correct. Then I'm going to pull that sentiment out again. So it comes from the Mischief Makers stamp set. There are some really fun sentiments in this stamp set. And this one says, "Happy birthday, Foxy Lady." I just thought that that was so fun. I stamped that down with some VersaFine Onyx Black ink. I did do it a couple of times because obviously you've got that stitching detail in the background and you want to make sure that the sentiment can be read really well through that stitching detail. Then I'm just going to use some liquid glue to attach my birch tree panel here onto the top of that nice stitched leaf background. And that will be the base of my card. And then I can start popping all of my images on top. Doesn't it look pretty? And doesn't it look so autumnal? I just love the colors. I'm definitely a fan of the autumn season. Okay, so once that was all smooshed down and I was happy with that, I'm pulling out my images again, but this time I've popped some foam tape on the back of them and I'm just going to pop them down with some foam tape just to give them a little bit of dimension, pop them off that background slightly. Then my little cake, I thought I would add some foam squares to that as well and just make sure that it was sticking out from the background and kind of just brings it forward a bit and makes that the real focal image, because you know, that beautiful background, it's hard to take your eyes off. Am I being a little bit big-headed there? But I love it. I just love it. Here are the leaves that I had colored, and I'm going to pop them scattered around the edge to look like they're floating away in that nice fall breeze. And I decided just to lay them down flat with some liquid glue. So once I had them all placed down, I'll pull out my liquid glue and adhere them all down in the correct placement. And through the magic of video editing, here it is all completed. I then pulled out this gorgeous new sequin mix. It's called a cherry pie. I love it. And I added some sequins to the top of my card base here. So all that's left is to glue it down to a card panel, and my card is complete. I hope you enjoyed this one today. I love these new products. I'm sure that you will too. The release drops on the 25th of September, but you can place pre-orders from tomorrow, the 18th of September. So be sure to head on over to the Happy Doodle website to do that. Make sure you check out all of the sneak peeks that we've been featuring over the last few days. So many gorgeous products. I'm sure you're going to fall in love with them. Thank you so much for joining me today. Take care, everybody.